You are utterly welcome to this week's Wintergatan Wednesdays, hosted by me and overconfident Martin, because I have built a HIHAT machine. So do you think it will work? Of course it will work. It's designed by me. Have I ever built anything that doesn't work? And have I ever stolen a joke from this old time? The hi-hat can rotate, and I cut this peg in the hi-hat. So now if I spin the beaters, you can see that they all hit this empty space. So the hi-hat is silent. But if I step the hi-hat over, we're gonna play the triplet notes. And the hi-hat can also play two channels at the same time. We can choose to play only quarter notes, or play quarter notes plus offbeat. Or only offbeat. So here's all the variations. The rotational position of the hi-hat is held in place by this half moon and a spring-loaded ball detent device. A mechanical wonder, something that gives meaning to life. In here is a ball bearing, and it gets pushed into these grooves, holding the rotational position of the hi-hat. And on the back of the spring-loaded ball detent, I have an adjustment screw. If I adjust it like this, the tension here will become bigger. I can adjust the sound of the hi-hat with this pressure screw here. Open. Close. On the back side, I have a microphone shock mounted to the shaft, so it will follow the rotation of the hi-hat, which means that no matter that the hi-hat is shifting position, the microphone will always capture the sound in the same way. In the last episode, I removed this swoosh swoosh earlier version that we spent a lot of time developing, but I can't be happier with this decision. Instead of the whooshy washy swoosh swoosh, we have a tick tick tick, a clean transient, which is the rhythm center of the Marmotine X. I had to exhaust all my skills to design and make and film this in just a couple of days, and it works. I'm really, really happy. I'm gonna buy an identical hi-hat as this one for this, but for now, I'm gonna work with this one. I was really curious to see if the sound of the hi-hat would remain intact after being cut into. I had no clue and I thought I just had to make an empirical study about it. And I kind of like the fact that the angle grinder does not only take, it also gives. After making the two halves identical and cleaning them up, I could try the before and after. I don't really like the sound of this particular hi-hat, and it was kind of low from the beginning and it got even a little bit lower after cutting, but still I thought it kept its sound quality pretty nice. It still sounds like a hi-hat, so I was happy with that and I could start working on the beaters, and I knew that I had to make much better beaters than what I had before with the spring steel. So I used some springs and I cut some drumsticks apart and I epoxied the whole thing together. And they look so cool. It's like a cartoonesque drumstick, isn't it? So I could disassemble the old beaters. They started to bend after a while and they just didn't work good. So I look forward to changing them.
So I over-engineered all these pieces with metal threaded inserts and built everything really modular if I needed to change beaters at a later stage. Et voila, that's exactly what I want to do now. So I think I should give a little credit to my younger self for the modular fashion in which I designed this. It's really nice.
So in this project, I used a kind of mix between improvising, cutting something, running down to the CNC machine, cutting something, improvising, cutting something, and I went like back and forth. I used CAD to block out the design, but I never like finalized the design in the computer. So here I'm machining the cavity for which the springs will fit into, and I could get a perfect fit, a little bit loose. It was hugely important that all the drumsticks sticked up the same length. So I could like cut from the bottom of the spring. When I cut exact amount of rings off, then I had the correct length and I could glue them in place. For the hi-hat machine to really work and be a success, I knew we had to have something that could adjust the position of each beater individually very precisely. And I designed this little clip, and here I'm actually burning the edge deliberately for those cool zebra stripes in the plywood. And with these glued on, we could then adjust the position of each beater with a set screw. And I used some felt pad to also dampen the mechanical sound. I really thought this would work great. So just when I was about to assemble everything onto the machine, it suddenly struck me. Do you remember I said it was important that all the beaters had the same length? That is not true. It's very important that the beaters have different lengths. Otherwise, they don't hit the radius of the symbol correctly. I don't know why I forgot this, because I had planned to make the beaters different length from the beginning of the process. I just forgot about it. So I had to backtrack and cut some of the beaters open and make them shorter. This was a huge setback and took a lot of time. Here you can see the height difference between a short beater in the middle and a long beater on the edge.
I have run into a problem. Listen to this mechanical sound. The spring makes a mechanical sound when it bounces back. Once I attach the piece to the circle, it gets worse. My idea was for this precision timing adjustment to have a little piece of felt there and do two jobs. Adjust the timing position of this and dampen this sound. Let's try. When I tighten this, the felt gets in contact with the spring and we can very accurately decide when this will hit the hi-hat. The timing works, but it's not killing the sound. Listen. And it gets worse. When I mount the circles on the marble machine, the whole marble machine becomes an acoustic chamber. I need to fix this.
Okay, so now is the time to start to think about how to mechanically switch channels and position the hi-hat. So this monstrosity is the center of everything we do. We're gonna put some felt washers. And here you can see I've cut a key in the top hi-hat. So now the hi-hat is locked rotationally onto this shaft. Felt washer. So this little thing is my favorite part that I made in a long time. I took a nut and I threaded two set screws in the bottom and I welded on this holder. It goes on like this. I can now point the mic holder straight to the sweet spot here. And then I can use these two set screws to key this to the shaft. So loose, a little harder, really tight. And then we have to make sure to key this to the shaft. Get this through, that looks good. I can aim the mic like this. I can put it in and out like that. I can get it really close. And when the hi-hat rotates, the microphone is always at the sweet spot, giving the same sound regardless of which rhythm channel is playing. Look how impressed he is. This assembly took all my skills, all my cutting and machining skills, some welding. It was so fun. So now to this part. Why is this here? Spring-loaded ball detent, woohoo! So in here I have a thin 12 millimeter hole that supports the sides of the spring. Chick. And then I can take this 15.875 millimeter ball bearing and I can lock it in place with this front. This is the adjustment screw. So if I want this ball to press harder, I can just turn this clockwise. It will press on the back of the spring and it takes much more force now to press the ball in. Sometimes I'm thinking about the meaning of life and existence, but this spring-loaded ball detent is, I think, the answer. So if you see down here, there's no grooves on this half moon. I wanted to wait until this very moment to make the grooves. So I was absolutely sure. So here, it's very clearly nothing is hitting. And I'm gonna make a mark. Let's move over, play the triplet. There is the triplet. Nothing else is playing. And then I want the combination, triplet 16th. Let's give it some speed. So now I can just sand a little groove exactly where I wanted the sound. Let's just try that. That is so cool. Meaning of life. You see how it snaps to it? I'm going to use the fine precision timing adjustment to calibrate the offbeat beater towards the whole note here. So you can see at this waveform that it already looks like a hi-hat with clear transients. Love it. And then we can actually measure in the waveform. Basically, very simple way to check is that I make a cut in the very beginning, I cut there. Let's just make the offbeat yellow so we remember. You can already see that we have clean transients from the hi-hat that we didn't have last week from the swooping spring steel. So here you can see that the yellow offbeat region is longer than the blue onbeat region. That tells me that the offbeat is tiny bit early. Let's check that in milliseconds. 2 milliseconds. Well, I'm claiming this is a precise adjustment, so we should be able to fix for that error. Let's head over to the machine and delay the offbeat channel a little bit. So this elastic that we use to remove the mechanical noise is now also the fine precision adjustment. So I want to push the beater this way to delay the offbeat channel, which gives, say, a quarter of a clockwise turn. There. That was 2 milliseconds, I think. Let's try again. Yellow is offbeat. Well, it's shorter. How much shorter? 1 millisecond. So a third of a quarter turn back. See if I can even see it happening. Yeah. Did we just fix 1 millisecond with an M8 bolt and some elastic? We line up the front edge and look at this back edge. Ah, still 1 millisecond off. So since we're not working with anecdotal evidence here on Wintergatan Wednesdays, we have to have our results repeatable. We have gone further than anyone else have gone in the precision of marble machines. Like Voldemort has gone further than anyone else have gone on the road towards immortality. I repeated the precision adjustment for the 16th and the triplets, and the HIHAT machine is starting to sound really good. So when I was at Spielklock Museum and I saw these professional automatas, a lot of them had drums positioned exactly like this, like vertical in the front, like this HIHAT. I think it finishes off the look of the marble machine and it gives the rhythmic center point that we need. Very, very happy for this. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks to everyone supporting us through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. Your support means so much. And most of all, thank you everyone for caring about this crazy Marble Machine X. See you next Wednesday.